Hello students, welcome to you all once again in your English class. Our today's topic is countable and uncountable noun, that is chapter number 3 of your English grammar. So students, when you hear the word countable and uncountable, so what do you gauge from the name? What do you think it could be? So I'm sure children you are very aware of these terms, countable and uncountable nouns, okay? So let's read countable and uncountable in detail, their technical meaning, their definitions, and whatever is countable and uncountable nouns. So now let's read in detail. So chapter number 3, countable and uncountable nouns. So nouns are naming words, and depending on whether a noun can be counted or not, it is classified as either a countable noun or uncountable noun. So as we know students, nouns are naming words, okay, and nouns can be counted or not. So it is classified into two categories, countable nouns or uncountable nouns, okay. So let's understand this with one example. Okay, so children, what do you see here? There are the images of books, balloons, water and rice, okay. So what do you see here? Images, okay. So what is the difference between these two images and these two images? Well, we can count the number of books, okay, and we can count the number of balloons. But can you count the number water in the glass? No, it is impossible to count water in the glass. Can you count the number of rice? No, it is also impossible to count the number of rice, okay. So well, we can count books and balloon. So let's count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So here are 5 books, and over here 1, 2, 3 balloons are here, okay. So we can count books and balloons, but we cannot count water in the glass and the number of rice, okay. So nouns, those nouns which we can count are called countable nouns, okay. So now let's read countable noun in detail, okay. So countable nouns are the names of the object, people or things that we can count. So the name of the object, people and things which we can count by using numbers, okay. So that is called countable nouns, okay. And how we identify countable nouns? When you get an answer to how many, then the things referred to are countable nouns, okay. Means when we ask question how many, okay. Means if I ask how many books were there? So you get an answer, 5 books were there, okay. And if I ask how many balloons were there, so you get an answer, 3 balloons were there, okay. So when we get an answer of how many question, then that is countable noun. They may be singular or plural, okay. So countable nouns always may be in singular form or in plural form. We can use a and the. So a and the, what it is called? It is called article, okay, with countable nouns. So we can use a and the with countable nouns. So let's see the example. Trees, cups, bags, tables, birds. So all these are the example of countable nouns. Why? Because we can count easily trees, cups, bags, tables and birds, okay. So countable nouns are available in both forms, singular and plural. Now let's see next, uncountable noun. So students, as the name suggests, uncountable means those nouns that which we cannot count are called uncountable nouns, okay. So now let's read uncountable noun in detail. Uncountable nouns are the names of the things which we cannot count using numbers, okay. So those nouns which we cannot count and we cannot use in numbers, that are called uncountable nouns. When we do not get an answer for how many and have to question how much, then the things referred to are uncountable nouns, okay. So how we identify uncountable nouns? When we do not get an answer of how many and we get an answer to how much question, okay. So that time we understood that it is uncountable nouns. Means how many we are using with countable and how much we are using with uncountable, okay. And many with we are using with countable nouns, and much we are using with uncountable nouns, okay. So I hope it is clear to you. They are always singular. So uncountable nouns are always available in singular form, okay, because we cannot count them, okay. only the can be used with uncountable nouns. Okay, so the article, only the we can use with uncountable nouns. We cannot use a and n with the countable uncountable nouns. Now let's see the example: wheat, milk, water, juice, sky, tea. So these are the example of uncountable nouns, because we cannot count wheat, milk, water, juice, sky and tea. We cannot say water, waters. We cannot say tea, teas. Okay, now let's understand this with one more example. So what you can what do you see here? Here is a glass of water and a bread slice. Okay, so as I told you students, we cannot count water in the glass. Okay, but we can count a glass of water. So if I ask how many glass of water is here, so you can easily get an answer that one glass of water. Okay, so we can count one glass of water, two glasses of water, three glasses of water. Okay, so a glass of water, it is countable, but water in the glass, it is uncountable. So as you can see here, bread. So bread, student, bread, if we say bread, so it is uncountable. Okay, but if we say a slice of bread, so it is countable. One slice of bread, two slices of bread, three slices of bread, so it is countable. So I hope you understood. Water, it is uncountable, but a glass of water, it is countable. Bread, it is uncountable, but a slice of bread, it is countable. So I hope the concept of countable and uncountable noun is clear to you. Now let's move into the exercises. Now this is your exercises, exercise number A. So we'll do the exercise, and the countable and uncountable nouns, it will be more clear to you. So now let's see the exercise. Underline the countable nouns and circle the uncountable nouns in these sentences. So what you have to do here? Underline the countable nouns and circle the uncountable nouns. So now let's read the sentence one. There are many restaurants in Bangalore. So students, which is uncountable noun is here? Restaurants, because we can count restaurants. So we can say that one restaurant, two restaurant, three restaurants. Okay, so restaurants, in restaurants, it is a countable noun. So I underlined it. Second sentence is, I need information about the tribes of Northeast India. So information, it is uncountable noun, students. Okay, so I circled here on information, and tribes, it is countable. Okay, so underlined it. Third sentence, my aunt owns several paintings by Raja Ravi Verma. So aunt, so here aunt and paintings, both are countable nouns. Okay, so I underlined it. Now let's see the next sentence. Fourth, I was disgusted to find a strain of hair in my food. So strain, students, it is countable noun, and hair and food, they both are uncountable nouns. Okay, so that's why I circled on the hair and food. Now let's see the next sentence. Please take as much rice as you need. So here rice, as I told you earlier also, rice, it is uncountable noun. Okay, so that's why we circled here. Meenakshi always takes a lot of photos when she goes abroad. So photos, students, photos, it is countable noun. Now let's see the next sentence. There aren't enough chairs in the classroom. So chairs and classroom, both are countable nouns. There's a lot of traffic today. So traffic, it is uncountable noun. My uncle gave me a great deal of advice. So uncle, it is countable noun, and advice, it is uncountable noun. Sunita has long black hair. So hair also, it is uncountable noun. Now let's move into the next exercise, exercise number B. So fill in the blanks with suitable words from the box. So here help box given to you. So you have to choose the word from that, and you have to fill this sentences that I already have done it. So sentence one, there weren't many boxes left. So boxes, it is countable. So what will write? Many boxes. Okay, as I told you earlier also, many we are writing with the countable noun, and much we are writing with the uncountable nouns. Now let's see the next sentence. Johnny has a lot of old toys. Third sentence, there is some ice cream left in the fridge. So ice cream, it is uncountable. Okay, so we can write some with uncountable. The curry needs a little salt. Sentence 5, help yourself to a piece of cake. Sixth sentence, there are still a few wolves in this woods. Next, I don't have any cash with me at the moment. Next sentence, I'm surprising my sister with a kitten. Okay, so as I told you students, A-N-A-N and the article we are using with countable. So here kitten, it is countable noun. Okay, so here A we used. The photo was taken at least 10 years ago. Because we are talking about a particular photo, that's why I have written here the. Would you give me some advice? Okay, so this was your exercise number B. Now let's see the next exercise C. Correct the errors in the sentences and rewrite them. Okay, so what you have to do, you have to correct the sentence. There is a mistake in the sentence, we have to correct it. So the sceneries in Nainital. So students, sceneries, it is uncountable noun. Okay, so as I told you, uncountable nouns, they do not have their plural forms. They always write in singular form. So what we have to correct here? Sceneries, it is wrong word. So we have to write scenery. That is the correct spelling of scenery. Okay, so the scenery in Nainital are beautiful. That is your correct sentence. It's not safe to drive during a rainy weather. So it is rainy weather, it is uncountable nouns. Okay, so we'll not write A with uncountable nouns. So here we have to cut A. So that is the error here. Now let's see the next sentence. The neighbors are unpacking lots of furnitures. Okay, so furnitures, again furniture, it is uncountable nouns. Okay, so uncountable nouns do not have their plural form. So we'll write only furniture. So the sentence will be, the neighbors are unpacking lots of furniture. Now let's see the next sentence. Many of India's history. So students, India's history, it is uncountable. Okay, so as I told you, we'll write with uncountable nouns much, not many. Okay, so was spent under colonial rule. So we have to write much of India's history was spent under colonial rule. So we have to write much. Many, it is wrong. Now let's see the next sentence. I have received no informations about the theft. So students, informations, it is uncountable noun. Okay, so will not uncountable noun do not have their plural. So information only, it is correct. We have to cut S from here. So the sentence will be, I have received no information about the theft. Now let's see the next sentence. Please call a local police immediately. Okay, so we are talking about a particular police. So we'll write, please call the local police immediately. Here A, it is wrong. So we have to write the. Now next seventh sentence. I heard these news at night. So news, it is uncountable noun. Okay, so we'll write the. So I heard the news at night. So this was all about your exercise, students. Please practice this exercise at your home also. Okay, next sentence 8. I hope you didn't go through many trouble to get there. So trouble, students, it is uncountable noun. So we have to write much trouble. Okay, so sentence will be, I hope you didn't go through much trouble to get there. Now next ninth, Rishan wants to work with the poors. So poor, students, it is uncountable noun. Okay, so we have to cut S from here. Okay, it's called poor only. So Rishan wants to work with the poor. Next sentence, the UN representatives are working for peace in many countries. So here what is the mistake? Peace, it is uncountable noun. So S we have to cut from here. Peace, okay. Now let's see the next sentence. Please pick your luggages on time. So luggages also, it is, students, uncountable noun. Okay, so uncountable nouns do not have plural. So we have to cut S from here. So the sentence will be, please pick your luggage on time. Now next sentence number 12. There are a few oranges in the baskets. Okay, so here they have written orange only. And orange, it is countable noun. Okay, so we have to write S with them. So there are a few oranges in the basket. Now let's see the next. How much bananas did you buy? So students, we know bananas are countable noun. Okay, so we have to write many. Much, it is wrong here. So we have to write many. How many bananas did you buy? Now let's see the next. I haven't got many time. So time it is uncountable. So we have to write much here, not many. So I haven't got much time left to complete the work. Now let's see the next. How many money? Money again also it is uncountable noun, students. Okay. So what we have to write? Much. How much money does he earn? Okay, so practice this exercise again and again, students, and I hope with this video lecture, countable and uncountable noun must be clear to you. So stay home, stay safe. Thank you.